Hello there. It's Monday, the 25th of April, a very special Anzac Day today, with the first year of unrestricted marches and dawn services return since the start of the pandemic.
People across the nation have gathered to honour our servicemen and women this morning. It's also the first Anzac Day since the withdrawal of Australian forces from Afghanistan.
As well, this year, Anzac Day marks the 60th anniversary of Australia's involvement in the Vietnam War. Between 1962 and 1972, Australia committed almost 60,000 personnel to Vietnam.
Normie Rowe, Australia's reigning king of pop, was one of them. Normie was at the pinnacle of his career when he was conscripted. He completed a tour of duty in Vietnam from January to December 1969. Normie joins us now from Sydney. Good morning, Normie. Thank you so much for joining us. What does Anzac Day mean
morning,
to you,
Jess.
Mate?
Good morning, Tristan.
Good morning.
Quite often, to be quite honest, I get asked what I'm going to be doing on Anzac Day, and I usually answer which one. For me, every day seems to be Anzac Day. There's always some ex-service, a question to be answered or issue to take care of. But this year is really important. It's showing up to be exactly what I thought it would be post-COVID, with people turning up to dawn services right around the country and lining the routes of March. I think it's going to be a fantastic day, although in Sydney here, as you can see, the weather's a bit inclement, but that's never stopped any ex-serviceman from marching previously.
That hasn't, and it's so important. There's some beautiful services going on this morning for sure. Normie, your own conscription, it's been described as a setup, a PR exercise, orchestrated in part by then Prime Minister Harold Holt. Is that your understanding of it?
Yes, it is, but I don't think it's an issue to be canvassed today. I think the most important thing at this moment today is to welcome home, if you like, the young veterans coming back from all the post-Vietnam era deployments, places like not just Afghanistan, of course, that's very recent, Iraq, of course, and Somalia, Namibia. On the border between Iraq and Iran years ago, we had peacekeepers. People don't realise that. And our ex-service, or our servicemen and women, do a mighty task of bringing the Australian sense of community and freedom to the rest of the world.
And then we talk about the silent war, you know, when veterans return. You suffered serious mental health issues after serving in Vietnam. Do you think the anti-Vietnam sentiment you copped when you returned to Australia, do you think that contributed to that, Normie?
Oh, absolutely. Rejection is one of the worst feelings of or emotions anybody can experience, and we certainly felt rejected. But I think overall the Australian public has realised, I guess, if they didn't realise it previously, that not to shoot the messenger, you
Absolutely.
Know. We were sent off and accepted our duty in good faith and sort of expected to come back. I know my dad said the best thing you can do is forget you ever went. You know, Dad gave me some wonderful advice, but I don't think that was one of the wonderful advice memories that I have.
Yeah. It's so important to say and for people to hear that. It's not our servicemen and servicewomen who decide to go to these places. Afghanistan vets, they're being encouraged to lead the Anzac Day march today in an attempt to avoid the same stigma that Vietnam vets were subjected to. Do you feel like this is a wise idea?
I don't think it's an attempt to avoid anything, to be quite honest. I think it's an attempt to honour those, from my point of view, young people who've come back and returned safely, and to remember those mates that they lost and remember the service that they did over there. You can bet your bottom dollar that in 20 or 30 or 40 or 50 years, when people think in Afghanistan about Australians, they will think very highly of them.
Normie, respect and gratitude is what we have for everybody today, Dahl. And what are your plans today? Are you marching? Are you going to do a bit of two-up?
No, I won't be doing any two up. I'm actually co-hosting on one of your opposition networks this afternoon.
That's
a very special event. It's called Lest We Forget. It'll be on the Seven Network, no commercials or anything like that. Mr. and Mrs. Stokes have decided that this is a tribute just for Anzac Day, and I think that's a wonderful thing. And I think all the channels are doing a wonderful job. All the radio stations who are covering it with such positivity are doing a wonderful job. And from my point of view, thank you very much.
Fantastic. Doesn't matter where you see it, as long as you appreciate and respect it.
Yeah, the only priority today is our service people. And Normie, we really appreciate you taking the time to join us and enjoy the rest of today. We think of you every day.
Thanks very much for having me on, guys. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thanks, Normie.